Hello friends, welcome to entranceadvisor.com. Today in this lecture I'll be talking about the photosynthesis in higher plants. Today I'll be focusing on only the major photosynthetic pigments. So let's start the video. Before that, if you are new to this channel, please hit the bell icon and do subscribe to our channel. So let's start. So how many pigments are involved in the photosynthesis process? Let's see. So pigments are the molecules that bestow color on the plants, algae and the bacteria, but they are also responsible for the effectively trapping sunlight. Pigments of different colors absorb different wavelengths of the light. Okay. The synthetic products of the plants formed as a result of the metabolic activities of cell and which play an important role in the photosynthetic process of the plants are called the photosynthetic pigments. About 1% of the total solar energy received by the earth is absorbed by the pigments and are used in the major photosynthetic process. Below are the three main groups. The major types of photosynthetic pigments that are involved are the chlorophylls, carotenoids and the phycobilins. In the year 1818, a scientist named Pelletier named the green colored pigments present in the plant cell as chlorophyll. Chlorophyll is present in the mesophyll tissue of the leaves. The photosynthetic process occurs within the chloroplast, and the plants may contain two types of pigments, green colored chlorophyll and the yellowish red colored carotenoid. And the chlorophylls are of two types, chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, of which the former is present in abundance. The carotenoids are of two types, orange colored carotene and yellow colored xanthophyll. Apart from chlorophyll C, D and E are also present apart from this. And other photosynthetic pigments are blue phycocyanin and lavender red phycoerythrin. So let's see what is written here. The chlorophyll are the green colored pigments that are capable of trapping blue and the red light. Chlorophylls have three subtypes dubbed chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B and chlorophyll C. According to Yugnim, Rabionowicz and Govindji in his book Photosynthesis Willy 1969, chlorophyll A is found in all photosynthesizing plants. There is also a bacterial variant aptly named bacteriochlorophyll which absorbs the infrared light. This pigment is mainly seen in purple and green bacteria which perform the anoxygenic photosynthesis. You got it? So chlorophyll molecules are arranged in a circle with the help of pyrrole rings with Mg atom at the center. We will see in the next slide what is the structure of the chlorophyll along with the pyrrole ring is attached to the phytol, a type of alcohol. So chlorophyll represents the green color of the plants. The chlorophylls are microcrystalline. Okay. They are located in the granular portions of the chloroplast in the higher plants. They form the monomolecular layer between the protein and the lipid layer in the granular lamellae. The hydrophilic heads of the chlorophyll molecules remain embedded in the protein layer, whereas the lipophilic phytol tails remain in the bilayer. You can see here is the diagram showing the, here you can see the chlorophyll A structure and the chlorophyll B. Only a slight difference, the porphyrin ring is shown in red. It is the magnesium attached to it and it is a phytol tail as you can see. Chlorophylls are insoluble in water and can be extracted only with the organic solvents like alcohol, ether, benzene, acetone and carbon disulfide. And the chlorophylls exhibit the property of the fluorescence, that is the property of the absorption of the radiation by a substance and its re-emission at longer wavelength. And the chlorophylls are the neutral substances changing its composition by the slight change of pH. There is slight change in pH and it changes its composition. It's very sensitive molecule. And chlorophyll synthesis occurs as a result of a series of biochemical changes within the cell. And factors which affect the chlorophyll synthesis are the genetic factors, light, oxygen, magnesium, metastrate, iron, copper, manganese, carbohydrate, nitrogen compound, and temperature. Chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B are present in higher plants, so no, and algae also. And chlorophyll C is present in diatoms and in brown algae. Chlorophyll D is present in the red algae, and the chlorophyll E is present in the Tribonema and zoospores of Vaucheria. And the bacteriochlorophyll are A is present in purple and the green bacteria, as you have seen in the previous slide. The bacteriochlorophyll B is present in the strains of the purple bacterium and in Rhodopseudomonas. Okay, and bacteriovidin is present in the green bacterium, and the chlorophylls mainly absorb violet, blue, and red parts of the spectrum and help in the photosynthesis. Chlorophyll B helps in storage of starch as reserve food. Coming to the second category of the pigment, these are carotenoids. These are red, orange, or yellow colored pigments, absorb bluish green sunlight, light. And the examples of carotenoids are the xanthophyll yellow and the carotene orange, from which the carrots get their color. So the orange and the yellow are the colors of the carotenoids. The orange carotene and the yellow are the xanthophylls, and together is called carotenoids. And these are fat soluble pigments. They are located in the chloroplast and in the chromatophore. And the carotenes are insoluble in water but soluble in alcohol, chloroform, benzene, etc., and the organic compounds, as they are soluble in fat, they are called lipochromes. And oxygenated carotenoid pigments are called xanthophylls. These are the yellow or the brown pigments. Carotenes and the xanthophylls are present in the algae and in the higher plants. And carotenoids absorb light energy in blue, blue-green, and the green parts of the spectrum. The general molecular formula of carotene is C40 and H56, and the general molecular formula of xanthophyll is C40. Will be coming to the molecular formula later on. You can see in the upcoming slides. And C40, H56, O2, and the carotenoids absorb light energy and transform it to a chlorophyll A. These pigments prevent the photodynamic damages within the photosynthetic apparatus, and structural formula of the beta carotene is shown here. In this, you can see. This focus on this part only. This is a structure of the beta carotene in this figure. Now coming to the third category, those are the phycobilins. These are the red or the blue pigments absorbed wavelengths of the light that are not as well absorbed by the chlorophylls and the carotenoids. They are seen in cyanobacteria and red algae. So phycobilins, these are the main group of the accessory plant pigments found in the certain algae. And these red and blue pigments are the phycoerythritin and phycocyanin, are collectively called phycobilins. You can see these are the phycobilins. These are phycoerythrobilin and phycocyanobilin, as I have said. You can utter the other name also. And those are phycoerythrin and phycocyanin, are the collectively called phycobilins. These are collectively known as the phycobilins. And the name was first proposed by the Lemberg in 1928. When they become active in the photosynthesis, they absorb energy and transmit energy to the chlorophyll. Phycoerythrins absorb green part of the spectrum. These are phycoerythrobilin absorb the green part of the spectrum, and the phycocyanins absorb the orange part of the spectrum. Okay, the structure of the red and green pigment phycobilins are shown in this image. Apart from that, there are another type of pigments known as anthocyanin pigments. The red, blue, purple color pigments found in the vascular sap of the plant cells are known as anthocyanins. And the color of the anthocyanin depends on the pH of the medium. In acidic medium, they appear red, whereas in neutral medium, they appear violet or purple. Increasing pH of the medium causes the blue color. Anthocyanins can absorb light within the range of 200 to 400 nanometer, and the maximum absorption is in the visible range. Due to their bright appearance, they are responsible for the bright color of the flowers and fruits. They help in the cross-pollination by attracting insects. They can also absorb light energy and convert it into heat energy. You can refer to many books. Here are some chemical formula along with the distribution written in a chart, so that you can memorize them easily, such as the main pigment is chlorophyll A and chlorophyll B, along with many others. And apart from that, you can find in many books the formula of the xanthophyll, phycocyanin, phycoerythrine, and carotene. I have said you several times, those formula are a little bit unnecessary, but not so much important in the board perspective. And these are obviously important in NEET perspective. So this is the chart. You can go through this. Here is a just flow diagram. You can see the chlorophyll A, chlorophyll B, xanthophylls, and carotenoids. Just to memorize this, I have written once again. And the maximum absorption of chlorophyll occurs in chlorophyll A in blue and red regions and having higher rate of photosynthesis. So the chlorophyll A is the chief pigment. And other thylakoids pigments such as chlorophyll B, xanthophyll, and the carotenoids are called the accessory pigments that absorb light and transfer energy to chlorophyll A and protect them from photooxidation. So here you can see in this graph, the chlorophyll B is in green color and yellow is in carotenoids, and chlorophyll A is in blue color. Absorbance is shown here and these are wavelength. Rate of photosynthesis, here is another diagram, and wavelength of light in nanometers. It is also given in your NCERT book. You may refer to that along with this video. Here is a clear diagram of the same reference, and chlorophyll A, this is chlorophyll in the, you can see in the blue region it's maximum, and in chlorophyll B after that, and after that these are carotenoids in the green region, you can see. And here is a human eye, the visible, the visual range, and it is the far red wavelength and it is ultraviolet. And remember, only the white light from the sunlight, all the seven colors of the visual, we can only see the green color. That's why the leaves are seen as green. Okay, only we can see the green color. The leaf pigments absorb most the colors but only reflect the green color. That's why our eye can perceive the green color only. I hope you understood well, and thanks for watching. If you like this video, please like, comment, subscribe. Take care. Goodbye.